Children, when we were small, we used to sit together and listen to Sushil Doshi and Ravi Chaturvedi's radio commentary on every cricket match that India played abroad. Each syllable and every exclamation we heard on radio made us feel like the match was unfolding right before us, even though the medium of communication was solely audio-based. You must be thinking, why all of a sudden I started talking about all this? Yes, today UNESCO is celebrating World Radio Day with the theme New World, New Radio. On this occasion, I would like to share few interesting facts about radio in India. In the year 1929, India got its first radio. Radio sets were imported to India and initially two radio stations were set up, one in Bombay and second one in Calcutta for news broadcasting only. The BBC began its broadcast in India in 1930s. On June 8, 1936, All India Radio was established. Since 1957, it is officially known as Akashvani, and this name was given by Rabindranath Tagore. Azad Hind Radio was a propaganda radio service started under the leadership of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in Germany in 1942 to encourage Indians to fight for freedom. Now let us talk more about All India Radio. Today, All India Radio has 415 radio stations and in 23 languages and 416 dialects. It has 99% population coverage and 18 FM channels. It is one of the largest broadcasters of the world. All India Radio's first ever news bulletin was broadcast on January 19, 1936. And the national musical program on All India Radio was broadcast on July 2, 1952. The Vivid Bharati service was on air on 3rd October 1957. It was one of the most popular service by All India Radio. The show helped Amin Sayani to become the most popular radio jockey till date. Signature tune of All India Radio was composed by Walter Kaufmann, a Czech Jewish refugee. This proves that music is truly a universal language and it does not know any barrier. The Shehenshah of Bollywood was rejected after an audition with All India Radio, so AR is indirectly responsible for giving India its most popular superstar, Amitabh Bachchan. Today also, a lot of people listen to radio mainly because it is affordable. It brings the young, old, poor, rich, everyone together. Radio provides high quality entertainment. Do you know, listening to the morning news on radio remains one of the most widely reported habits across the globe. Radio has been the last man standing in times of calamity and disaster. During 2004 tsunami and 2013 Uttarakhand floods, radio played a stellar role in providing information on relief work, aid and recovery efforts when networks were down and phone lines were cut. Radio, this source of entertainment has a lot of advantages in a country as diverse as India. deviant films are in few languages. In India, there are over 180 local community radio stations which operate in languages of most tribes and communities. Rural India relies on this medium heavily for information. Our country still struggling to achieve higher and better literacy. Radio acts as a medium to give knowledge and information even to the illiterate. Radio Mirchi in Mumbai and Delhi has a weekly listenership about 7 million people. Our Prime Minister uses radio for his Mann Ki Baat so that he can reach every part of our country, no matter how remote it is. From All India Radio speakers with a steady tone to playing peppiest Bollywood numbers, radio has learned to evolve with people. Survey says 159 million radio listeners are there in India, in compared with 176 million internet users. Today, the spread of internet is not competition for radio, but rather is supporting development. Radio stations have started launching websites, so radio is not a technology that will become obsolete. It still remains the cheapest and the most reliable source of entertainment and information. It adapts with changing technologies and new trends. Radio is now accessible through laptops, computers, phones, and even smart speakers. So you can tune your favorite station whenever and wherever you want. TV gives everyone an image, but radio gives birth to a million of images in a million of brains. It is the most powerful tool that informs, transforms, and unites us. Radio is about companionship and emotional connection with the listeners. On this occasion of World Radio Day, we must remember that inventions never vanish. They just keep on changing their formats and evolving. Bring the world closer and honor radios. Happy World Radio Day!